the life of an incredible, incredible woman. We celebrate Lisa today and her homegoing to see Jesus. Don asked if we would start this time with worship together. So if you would please stand with me. We're going to begin our time together with worship.
Where Jesus bled and died for me, I see his wounds, his hands, his feet, my Savior on that cursed tree. His body bound and drenched in tears, they laid him down in Joseph's tomb. The entrance sealed by heavy stone, Messiah still and all alone. Oh, praise the name of the Lord our God. Oh, praise his name forevermore. For endless days we will sing your praise. Oh Lord our God. Then on the third, at break of dawn, the Son of Heaven rose again. Oh, trampled death, where is your sting? The angels roar for Christ the King. Oh, praise the name of the Lord our God. Oh, praise his name forevermore. For endless days we will sing your praise, O Lord our God. He shall return in robes of white, the blazing sun shall pierce the night, and I will rise among the saints, my gaze transfixed on Jesus' face. We sing, oh, praise the name of the Lord our God. Oh, praise his name forevermore. For endless days we will sing your praise, O Lord our God, O Lord our God.
Oh, Jesus, we worship you today, God, knowing that today Lisa stands in your presence praising you, Lord. She's gazing upon the Savior that she loved so much, basking in the glory of who you are, Jesus.
We fall down, we lay our crowns at the feet of Jesus. The greatness
Asked me to share a scripture reading with you from 1 Corinthians chapter 13. Love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not parade itself. It is not puffed up. Love does not behave rudely. Love does not seek its own. It is not provoked. Thinks no evil. Does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. But whether there are prophecies, they fail. Whether there are tongues, they will cease. Whether there is knowledge, it will vanish away. For we know in part and we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect has come, then that which is in part will be done away. When I was a child, I spoke as a child. I understood as a child. And I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now we see in a mirror, dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then I shall know, just as I also am known. And finally, verse 13, and now abide in faith, hope, and love, these three. But the greatest of these is love. And love is the perfect word to summarize Lisa's life. Such a loving, caring, smiling lady that we'll all miss. Thank you.
I have the privilege of sharing the eulogy. I want to make a comment. The eulogy was extremely well written. Not only well written, but the heart of who Lisa was and her testimony here. So, Lisa Denise Hughes was a kind, gracious soul with the warmest heart and a strong, loving faith. She was an extraordinary daughter, mother, grandmother, sister, aunt, wife, and I'll add to that, friend. Lisa's captivating personality and charm was undeniable, and she was able to immediately make friends with everyone she encountered. From the random stranger in line at a store to the cashier desperately trying to get through their shift, her daughter Jennifer often shook her head and smiled as they were leaving a store, because as she looked back, she would yet again find her mom holding up the line, chatting and befriending the cashier right then and there over something as silly as the fun color of the socks she was buying, instantly brightening their day. She had a lighthearted sense of humor and loved to laugh. At every family gathering, Lisa anticipated the joy of spending time with everyone, especially her children, who always made her smile. Her son Jeffrey had a boisterous personality and without doubt always had the room laugh from Lisa. His mom would constantly cackle and shake her head at the silliness that ensued. Lisa's smile lit up the room. She found comfort and true happiness, moments cherishing each fun memory. They say a mother's love knows no bounds. Lisa's love for her children was unconditionally love, a selfless love that provided comfort and encouragement, confidence and protection to her children with great measure. Lisa not best she could, but she often mothered their many friends and anyone who came through her doors. Lisa also was incredibly proud to be a grandmother and kids. Her love shines through each and every one of them every day. The joy faces had when Grandma Lisa was around was unforgettable. She was one, even when she was struggling through pain, to get down on the floor and play and express her unquestionable love. Even if she did not always have an answer, Lisa always found a way to comfort, support, and be present to anyone in need at any time. That was Lisa's MO, thinking of others before herself. She always wanted to share her love and give of herself, even if she didn't have the energy to do so. Lisa was selfless and tremendously brave in all her battles. Her heart was so big, it often filled her with immense emotion, which was one of her most compelling characteristics. One could always feel her passion for people, animals, and all of life's ups and downs. Beyond the face of adversity and tremendous pain, Lisa had an unwavering determination to perform the little things that often made us feel the most loved. From ensuring her grandson that he had birthday money to buy his favorite Lego set, to setting a daily alarm in her husband's phone, reminding him to take his medications, something she'd never let him forget, even from the throes of her hospital bed. Without doubt, this is the legacy that Lisa leaves behind, to give and to share love. Although Lisa had always possessed strength within herself, it wasn't until she experienced one of the greatest gifts her family would be blessed with that she was able to tap into the full potential of her strength, the gift of when her husband Don walked into her life, and that had changed her life forever. She often spoke to her children of how blessed she was to have Don in her life, especially when she felt she least deserved it. He was able to bless her with endless love and invaluable gifts like patience and compassion and reintroducing her to the love of God. With his love and their journey in faith, Lisa was able to live a fruitful life and fight for as long as she could. With his help through triumph and tragedy, she always upheld her self-awareness with the utmost clarity and gave her the ability to always shine. Lisa will forever be in our hearts. Her love and graciousness for others will live on through her children, her grandchildren, her family, her friends. Her strength and determination will always be a reminder to us to persevere when things get tough. In the words Lisa passed on to her children at every goodbye, "I love you to the moon and back." Let me pray. Father, we do thank you. We thank you for the time we've had with Lisa, and I pray that as we have now a time of open sharing, I pray that we would carry the baton, that we would just continue the race. And we're thankful for all the lessons that we've learned from Lisa and what a blessing she was. Amen. So we're going to have a few individuals come up now and share, and again, these are individuals that were very close. And of course, I know there's hundreds more, and we could be here for hours. But we're going to begin with Judy.
All right, this is hard. Here I go. God's given me something more than family. Lisa was not only my sister, but she was my dearest and most treasured friend. Over these last few weeks, I've been praying and asking God why. She's such an amazing person, so loving, so caring, so selfless, and too young to leave us so soon. While it doesn't make the heartache any easier, maybe I need to be influenced by Lisa's selflessness and love to realize perhaps she was needed more in heaven than here. So I found this poem that I'm going to share with you that's helped me. Don't grieve for me, for now I'm free. I'm following the path God laid for me. If my parting has left a void, then fill it with remembered joy. Be not burdened with times of sorrow. I wish you the sunshine of tomorrow. Perhaps my time seemed all too brief. Don't lengthen it now with undue grief. Lift up your heart and share with me. God wanted me now. He set me free. Lisa loved us all unconditionally and has been my true inspiration. She will live everywhere I go. She will be in everything I see, and she will live in every turn I take. And there won't be a day that goes by that I won't think of her.
Thank you, Judy. Hannah?
Thank you. One of the last and best memories I had with Lisa was just a few months ago. I went to visit her in the hospital, and it was just the two of us hanging out, laughing, you know, what girls do. Throughout the day, Lisa kept asking me, are you okay? Do you need anything? Can I do anything for you? Lisa was that kind of person. She was the most selfless and the biggest servant in the room, no matter who was there. I'll never forget one particular moment in this day. In this time, Lisa was too weak to use the bathroom by herself, so they had a portable toilet in the room, and she kept apologizing, I'm sorry, I have to use the bathroom in front of you. And the only thing that I can think and say to her was, why are you apologizing? We're just two girls going to the bathroom together. I'll never forget how hard she laughed. Although I only had a few short years of being close to Lisa, that's all it took for me to know that I wanted to imitate her love for God and for people. Lisa's joy and love could be felt by anyone she interacted with. Her strength and trust in the Lord pushed her and her family through some of the hardest times. And despite every battle and trial she faced, she was still one of the most courageous women of God I have ever met. Although Lisa is no longer physically with us, her spirit lives on. Her example and light will shine to all who knew her. One of the greatest blessings in my life was getting to know Lisa, and I hope that I could share that blessing with the people that I come in contact with. Until we meet in heaven once again, I will hold on to the memories we have together. Just two girls loving God and doing what girls do.
Brianna Cronin, come on up. Oops.
Over the past few weeks, I've been remembering and thinking through the memories that I got to share with Lisa. We've traveled to a different country together and spent a lot of time together. And as I thought through those memories, one word stood out, and that was servant. No matter where we were, in Africa or at church or in our home, Lisa always served people. She always was serving. Didn't matter who it was or where she was or how she was feeling, she loved people more than herself and always cared about how others were doing and how she can help them and love on them. she served along, we served alongside each other in multiple places. And I remember thinking back through those memories and just realizing how much of an impact she had on my life by setting that example. She put others first, not because of who she was, but because of who her love for God was and how much she loved him. And she wanted others to see that and know that they were loved. I started going through our text messages, and the last message she had sent me was, "I'm starting to feel a little bit better. I can't wait till I can get back in church and start serving again." And that was Lisa's heart. Even though she had been sick, she would find ways that she could still participate. She could still serve in her church body and care about others. I remember she wanted to serve at Trunk or Treat so bad, and she wasn't feeling very well. And so we got her a stool, and she found a spot, and she took care of welcoming thousands of people into our church's event. And that was just her. She always had a smile on her face. And so I hope you guys remember, as I've been thinking through this, and just reminded that she would want us to realize that she did that because she loved Jesus. And she'd want us to know that even though she's not here, that she loved him and she loves us. And I'm so thankful for this woman that I hope to emulate as I, over the years, can be a servant just like she was.
Thank you, Graham. You're going to see a video in a moment. My wife's in Uganda, and Lisa was a dear friend and sister. And so Sandy's actually at an orphanage that we have there sharing from Uganda.
I wanted to say a few words about my friend. I had a sweet friend named Lisa. She loved Jesus a lot. One of the things that most impressed me about my friend was that she was a servant. No matter what I was doing, no matter what I was involved in, no matter where I was going, she wanted to be involved in it, and she wanted to help. So there was times where I was overwhelmed with things, and Lisa jumped in. Sometimes it was just Lisa who would be there with me. Sometimes it was just her and I doing big projects and big events. But she saw me, and she saw the need, and she jumped in every single time. I could count for the next hour how many times this woman saw me doing and jumped in alongside me. She was my partner. We did a wedding together. We went to Uganda together. We cleaned out my mom's house and her closet together. It was Lisa who was that person who always saw the need and met it. I'm gonna miss my friend. And I only hope that I could be a small portion of the servant that she was. I'm gonna start to look for needs the way she looked for needs. I can't wait to see you again, Lisa. And I'm so thrilled to think that you are with your Heavenly Father. You're right where, exactly where you want to be. By the way, Lisa, I can't be there today, as you know, because I'm in Uganda, which was one of your favorite places, I know. So when I'm there, I'm going to be remembering you. I love you, and I will see you very soon.
I'm just going to share for a moment my testimony at my time. Obviously includes Don, because several years before I met Lisa some 17 years ago. And I began with kind of a critical eye. Okay, all right, who's Don got that he's gonna go ahead and spend their eternity with as far as on this earth? And it was very quickly that I knew this lady was special. And as my wife just said, we pastored a church up in Lake Arrowhead. And they drove up there for a year. Every Sunday they were there. Sometimes they were there Wednesday nights. Thought about buying a house up there. And as my daughter said and my wife said, we constantly just saw Lisa serving with a big smile on her face, just constantly wanting to do more. Fast forward. 3.5 years ago, after living in Uganda, coming back here to the desert, and you've heard this, Lisa just walked out on selfishness. And if she were standing before you today, her testimony would be, because of Jesus living in me. I always thought of others first, and she did. She was constantly trying to minister to Sandy and I, even though I was her pastor for a year, and even though I co-labored with her, and she's a friend, constantly at that place. And I believe Lisa would say this to all of us, for me to live, as the Bible says, is Christ, because that's what she did. And for me to die is gain. But as I heard, I love you to the moon and back, and don't forget it. Lisa was one special lady, and I'm not going to go on anymore because I think we've heard so much. I'm going to have a video, photo, slideshow, again, reflecting on Lisa. But as you see all these photos, just remember it was Jesus in her. That is the greatest testimony of all.
From the darkness, I called your name. Into darkness, your mercy came. You called me out, lifted me up. How great is your love? You bore my weakness, you took my shame. You
amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You laid down your life. That I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me.
We've heard so many things about Lisa today and barely scratched the surface of the kind of lady that she was and what she accomplished. And I was thinking when you would, what she'd suffered for several years, and you'd watch the way that she did that, it was like royalty. It was like anything I've never seen. You'd walk into a hospital room and you'd feel like you were honored, you know, and it was just, that's who she was. She was absolutely beyond my ability to add anything. Just incredible amount of love. For the past several weeks, I've been just reading about heaven in the Word, and trying to get everything I can get from that. And I don't have any answers. I haven't come up with any great intellectual statements. The Bible says we see through a glass now darkly, but then face to face. We're very limited by what we can see. And I have all kinds of questions that I would like answered. And I don't have most of those answers, so I'm not going to try to do that today. But I wrote down some notes as I've been reading and studying, and just kind of wanted to share with you some things that happened with Lisa. It's the fleeting years here on this earth are just a very small, minuscule portion of our journey, you know, through eternity. There's another whole realm of life beyond this sphere in which we live. It's a place where God will make right all the wrongs in this life. It's a place where we will know life from a richness and a fullness that we've never known here. And as believers, the Bible puts it this, we are simply pilgrims journeying into our heavenly home, strangers and pilgrims on this earth. So I thought I would just give you a few scriptures and just what Lisa's doing right now, from what the scriptures say and what happened to her. And the first thing I saw was she experienced rest. Listen to this verse. Revelation chapter 14, verse 13. Then I heard a voice from heaven saying to me, write, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on. Yes, says the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors and their works follow them. For the believer, heaven is a hope of rest. To die in Christ means we enter into rest. Lisa is released and free from all the burdens, all the labor of this world. When Adam sinned, God cursed this world and said that man was to live by the sweat of his brow. Since then, we've been toiling and working in this world to survive, and there is really no true rest as long as we're here. But God has prepared heaven as a place where we can rest from our labors. There'll be no more battles of the flesh, no more battles with sin, no more battles with the devil. Lisa is experiencing complete rest from every pressure and negative thing that she could ever experience. That is over. She is resting like she was never able to rest before. There's also reward. It says in Revelation chapter 5, verse 12, rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For a believer, there's this hope of a glorious reward. When Lisa showed up, there was a reward or rewards waiting for her. God is faithful to reward us for everything we've ever done for Christ, every bit of her service, every bit of her serving, every bit of taking something from somebody else that was burdensome and taking that and walking that for them. She's rewarded for every one of those things that she did. Incredible, man. Christians are sometimes feel like they're forgotten or unappreciated. Many times they get hurt by ingratitude and selfishness. But in heaven, we've been promised a due reward for every single thing we've ever done. There's also rejoicing. Listen to this one, Revelation 21:4. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away. Heaven is a place of eternal joy and happiness. No sorrow, no sadness, no sickness, no suffering, no pain. Lisa experienced more than her share of tragedies and suffering in this world. But in heaven, when she showed up, God was standing there, and the Bible tells us that he wiped away every tear from her eyes, and she will never weep, nor hurt, nor be in pain again. She will forever live in rejoicing and happiness. I also found that there's reunion in heaven. 1 Corinthians 13:12, the Apostle Paul declared, "Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known." 1 Thessalonians 4:13 says, "Brothers and sisters, we don't want you to be uninformed about those who sleep in death, so that you do not grieve for the rest of mankind who have no hope." For us, for believers, there is this hope of reunion. In heaven, there is reunion of all of our loved ones who have gone before us. God gives us the great hope of this resurrection for all who die in Christ. The Bible says we don't need to grieve as others grieve who have no hope. Lisa's hope, and we talked about it, and we had discussions about it, and she would share, you know, her heart, and she understood that, man. Her loved ones, every person that she loved that knew Jesus Christ and have died in him are in heaven, and she's already with them. And there is a reunion that's beyond anything my mind can begin to comprehend. It's also the resurrection. 1 Corinthians 15:51-54 says this, "Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible has put on incorruption and this mortal has put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory." Just as Jesus Christ rose from the dead, all those who are in Christ will rise again. That resurrected body is free from sickness and weaknesses and limitations. There's also residence. Listen to this, John 14. "In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself. From where I am, there you may be also." We live our time, and I've said this a moment ago, we live our time on earth as strangers and pilgrims. And the Lord comforts us. And he says, "I'm going, and you're going to find me there. We're going to meet again. And because in my Father's house are these many mansions, these many dwelling places. If it were not so," he said, "I would have told you, but I'm telling you the truth." So that helps us to face the day that we have all of this to look forward to. It also says in Romans chapter 8, "For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us." Hebrews 12:2, "Looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God." Jesus tells him, he says, "I'm telling you that the place I'm going is absolutely incredible, and God has prepared this for you." He said, "If it wasn't so, I would tell you. I'm telling you the truth." He's preparing a place for each one of us. The word prepare means to make ready. It was used to describe the custom of sending people before kings that are on a journey. The roads would be leveled and be cleared of obstacles. This is a fitting word for us as we are special to Christ. We are his bride. The Lord blazes a trail, and we are going to follow him. He is preparing heaven for us. Just think what Lisa is experiencing right now. And beyond all of that, she experienced her Redeemer. Listen to Revelation 19. "Let us be glad and rejoice and give him glory, for the marriage of the Lamb has come, and his wife has made herself ready. And to her it was granted to be arrayed in fine linen, clean and bright, for the fine linen is the righteous act of the saints. Then he said to me, write, blessed are those who are called to the marriage supper of the Lamb. And he said to me, these are true sayings. For the believer, there is hope of an intimate relationship with our Redeemer in heaven. We're going to see him face to face and be forever in his presence. We have believed him by faith. Lisa served him by faith. Lisa trusted him by faith. She loved her Savior even though she had not seen him face to face. But in heaven, the day she took her last breath here, she took her next breath in the presence of Jesus Christ. We will enter into a relationship with him as his bride. Heaven is heaven, and all these things we can talk about, and there's a million things more. But heaven, the truth of heaven and the excitement of heaven is because God is there. Have you ever been someplace and you really like it and you say something like, oh, this is heaven. I wish I could never leave here. This is so exciting. You know, something you felt, something you saw. I want to tell you, whatever it was in heaven. It might have been a beautiful feeling. It might have been a magnificent place, but not heaven. Heaven is heaven because God is there. Heaven will be heaven to you because you are precious to him. He will bring you close to him. Look in your eyes as he did Lisa's and just say, I love you. Welcome to what I've prepared for you. And Don, if we could call Lisa back right now, as much as she loved you, and there are a few couples I've met that had the love that you two had for each other. It was apparent to everybody that knew you, the way you treated each other and talked about each other. And so there's no doubt how much she loved you. But I want to tell you, no matter what I would tell her, she wouldn't come back. Because what she's experiencing right now far exceeds anything any of us can ever experience in this life. She won't want to leave. She'll never want it to end, and it won't. Eli Singer wrote the lyrics to the chorus, and Don Wurtson put it to music. Just think of stepping on a shore and finding it heaven, of touching a hand and finding it's God's, of breathing new air and finding it celestial, of waking up in glory and finding your home. It's exactly what happened to Lisa. The scriptures says to us that death is going on a journey. In 2 Timothy 4:5, we read Paul at the end of his life, and he says this, I'm already poured out like a drink offering, and the time has come for my departure. The word departure is a fascinating one. It's used of the striking of a tent. We're planning to move our location, so we loosen the ropes and we take the tent down. Departure was also used for the untying of a boat from its mooring. The anchor is weighed. The ropes are loosened. We put out to sea, and we head for a different shore. And before the great adventure of this, of a new voyage, Paul looks back over his ministry of 30 years and says, I fought the good fight. I finished the race. I kept the faith. The Christian life is viewed realistically. It's a battle. The opposition is relentless. The bullets are real. The casualties are high. But that is all over for Lisa. She is now experiencing the incredible peace and presence of the one she put her hope of her entire life in, her Lord Jesus Christ. In Acts chapter 20, with the Ephesian elders, Paul said that the goal of his life was to finish the race, complete the work that God had given him to do. May I remind you that the race is only won at the end. And Lisa finished hers. She completed everything that God had for her to do. And then finally Paul speaks to those who have kept the faith. They guarded the treasure, even though it meant pain and suffering. In each there's labor, sacrifice, and danger. But now, says Paul, nothing else remains, just the crown. And that's your Lisa. That's where she is right now. Father, as we sit before you for just a few more moments, as I just want us to take a time to meditate, to take a time as sometimes we speak of heaven and we know it's a place and we want to go, but Lord, open up our understanding. Let us understand that we're just on a journey to see you. One day we'll see you. One day we'll see Lisa. One day we'll see our other loved ones who have gone before us, Lord. I thank you for that confidence and that hope. I would pray and I would know that from the bottom of my heart that Lisa would not want me to finish without making certain that every person in this room, Lord, knew that she is where she said she was going, that heaven is real, that Jesus Christ is the way and she's there. And she would want every family member, every friend, every acquaintance to have the same confidence that she had. As the days got shorter and shorter for Lisa, Lord, I heard her talking more and more about where she was going than where she'd been. So, Lord, I pray that there would be that reality with everyone here, that everyone here would know that you spoke one day and said, you are the resurrection and the life. He that believes in you will never die spiritually. But if we die physically, we will live forever spiritually in your presence. And you said, whoever believes in you, if there are those here today, Lord, that have not made that decision to believe in you, that you would speak to their hearts. And just very simply, that they would even as I'm closing in prayer, they would just at this moment just say to you, Jesus, I don't understand everything, but I want the hope that Lisa had. I want the hope of eternity. I choose to believe that, Jesus, you came and that you are God and that you died in my place. And I receive you into my life. Lord, I would pray that that would be spoken by individuals here to you. And then, Lord, you would lead them and guide them in their walk through eternity. And Lord, I thank you personally that you allowed me to know this incredible, incredible woman, Lisa Hughes, Lord. It's in your name that I pray, in the name of Jesus. Amen. I want to stand for this closing song.
I was excited when Don asked me to sing this song because I can see Lisa, this side of the room, just a few rows from the back, singing it with everything she had. And the first time I played it, she met me in the back. She goes, you know that song, Death Was Arrested? I said, yeah. She goes, that's a good one. You should do it again. I said, okay, I will. Just for you. Let's sing together.
My sorrows and dead in my sin, lost without hope with no place to begin. Your love made a way to let mercy come to me when death was arrested and my life began. Ash was redeemed, only beauty remained. My orphan heart was given a name. My morning grew quiet, my feet rose to dance when death was arrested and my life began. Oh, your grace so free washes over me. You have made me new now. With you, it's your endless love pouring down on us. You have made. much new now life begins with you. Release from my chains, I'm a prisoner no more. My shame was ransomed, faithfully bore. He canceled my debt, he called me his friend. When death was resting, my life began. Oh, your grace, so free, washes over me. You have made me new, now life begins with you. It's your endless love pouring down on us. You have made us new, now life begins with you. Oh, your grace so free washes over me. You have made me new, now life begins with you. It's your endless love pouring down on us. You have made us new, now life begins with you.
Amen. Would you join me as we close in prayer? Father, we ask the same love you poured into Lisa's life would now be poured out upon the family and friends that are here today. As Lisa chose to walk in joy, even through the most difficult of situations, Lord, may we too find our hope and our joy and our peace and our comfort in you. So we thank you, Lord, for the work you did in and through Lisa's life, Lord. We pray now for the family. We ask, God, that you would continue to walk with them, that you, Father, would lead them and guide them, that you would fill them, Lord, top to bottom with your peace that surpasses all of our human understanding, Lord. Would you bring them your comfort, we ask, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Well, this concludes our service today. The family would like to invite every single one of you next door to our fellowship hall. We'll have some food and drink for you. And on behalf of Pastor Chuck and the staff here, we thank you for joining us. And we want to let you know, please take your time. Don't feel rushed to leave. Hang out in here, move next door, but the place is yours for as long as you need it today. So take some time to fellowship and hang out with one another. God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you.